Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Today's Mass will be offered for Brian O'Leary, and we are in the fifth day within the octave of the Nativity of the Lord. And it's also the feast day of St. Thomas Becket. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness, for he is full of gentleness and compassion. Lord Jesus, you bring us strength in time of trial. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring healing to the sick and the suffering. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Amen. Peace to the people of your will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who gave the martyr St. Thomas Becket the courage to give up his life for the sake of justice, grant that through his intercession, that renouncing our life for the sake of Christ in this world, we may find it in heaven. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, the way we may be sure that we know Jesus is to keep his commandments. Whoever says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. This is the way we may know that we are in union with him. Whoever claims to abide in him ought to walk just as he walked. Beloved, I am writing no new commandment to you, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. And yet I do not write a new commandment. I do write a new commandment to you, which holds true in him and among you, for the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light, yet hates his brother, is still in the darkness. Whoever loves his brother remains in the light, and there is nothing in him to cause a fall. Whoever hates his brother is in darkness. He walks in darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
The Lord made the heavens, splendor and majesty go before him. Praise and grandeur are in his sanctuary.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. and the glory of your people Israel.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the days were complete for their purification according to the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Just as it is written in the law of the Lord, every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, Lord, now let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal to you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him, and Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself, a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
St. Thomas Becket was an archbishop in London at the time of the King Henry II, that happened in the 12th century. And he was probably the foremost theologian of his day, respected throughout Christendom. And he and the King of England were very close friends. But the King of England wanted his own way. He wanted to have the power over what would be said and done in the church. And so he wanted to usurp the authority even of the Pope of Rome. Thomas the Becket tolerated this for a while, and King Henry named him the Archbishop of Canterbury, a most prestigious place to be. But King Henry grew very impatient with him because he would not agree to what King Henry wanted. And as I said, he wanted to be, you might as well say, the Pope of the Church of England, which was later to be created by King Henry VIII because Rome refused to annul his marriage. And as you know, he had many marriages, and he had all of his wives beheaded up until the last one. At any rate, in his intolerance of Thomas the Becket, he sent his guards to arrest him, but better still, they went into the cathedral in Canterbury while he was celebrating Mass, and they murdered him. And if you have any knowledge about Broadway, they put on a Broadway show entitled Becket. There was also a drama, Murder in the Cathedral. But to this very day, all Christendom recognizes Thomas the Becket as what he was, a foremost theologian, a martyr, truly a saint. And now let us continue with our prayers of the faith. Like Simeon, who trusted in the light of Christ, we approach the Lord with confidence and present our petitions for the church, that Christ continue to illuminate our path to unity throughout the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political leaders of every nation, may the humble birth of Jesus inspire a renewed commitment to peace building and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering or burdened with difficulty, may the hope found in the Lord's faithfulness and promise bring them consolation and great joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who are suffering or burdened with difficulty may trust in the Lord and realize that He is always with them and loves them dearly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Brian O'Leary, for whom this Mass is offered, and our own deceased loved ones and parishioners, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And that through the intercession of St. Thomas Becket, our prayers, which we now include in silence, will be heard and answered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we entrust ourselves to you by living as faithful followers of your Son. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. The tree of goodness, we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us this spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and honor of all his holy Church.
Sanctify our offerings by your blessing, Lord, and by your grace. May we be set afire with that flame of your love through which St. Thomas Becket overcame every bodily torment through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, when
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember Brian O'Leary and all of our brothers and sisters, including our own deceased loved ones and parishioners who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Thomas Becket, St. Elizabeth of Hungary, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May this mingling the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacred mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, give us that determination which made your blessed martyr, St. Thomas Becket, faithful in your service and victorious in suffering. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael,
your archangel, defend us now. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world, seeking to ruin souls.
Amen. Have a good evening.